Good morning. Today, I decided to take you along for a realistic day in my life. What I didn't realize was just how typically me and realistic this day would actually be from morning to evening. Everything starts at 7:30, way too early for my liking. Especially when I went to bed at 2:30 last night after being engrossed in reading. The reason I tortured myself by waking up so early will quickly become apparent. I get ready and rush to the station. Once downstairs, I realize there is a 100% chance of it raining at any minute. I make a quick risk calculation on whether I miss the bus or get an umbrella, but then realize the decision is actually made for me because I have no idea where my umbrella is. I stop by the store to pick the only non-sugary breakfast option. It feels as though I could have bought a whole hen for this price, but I'd rather have the extra 5 minutes of sleep. Realizing my happiness actually comes at a reasonable price, I manage to catch the bus to the hospital. I make it to the day surgery clinic, but it's my first time in the building. After a painfully muffled and therefore awkward interaction with the nurse at reception, I get given a temporary card to get changed into scrubs. The first time at a new hospital building is a nightmare. I must have asked about 3 different people for directions to the scrubs room. The women's changing room was flooded, so I had to fumble about in a toilet, and by the time I was ready to make it to theatre, I still haven't eaten. Unless you're the patient, going into surgery on an empty stomach is a really bad idea. Although theoretically, my stomach rumbling can distract the doctors from my wrong answers on anatomy, it really just adds layers to the embarrassment. So the reason I was up so early today was to attend this ophthalmology surgery. I'd never been in one before, and last Monday, the consultant was super kind and generous with offering I join. After 3 hours, I confirmed that I really don't feel uncomfortable with stabbing, poking, injecting, or cutting eyes. Maybe it's because I wear contacts and I'm used to it. It's now almost time for my actual scheduled teaching today. I first need to eat. I head off to Costa and get myself a toastie, which I have on my computer. I first make sure emails are all sorted and then write up 2 patient cases I saw this week, send them over to my consultants to sign off, log in my surgery from today, and then reflect on another case I saw in my portfolio. I then wonder which clinical examination we're most likely to be requested to do today. I'm currently on my neurology bunk, which is honestly my favourite speciality so far, by far. I decide it's likely to be lower limb, so I quickly revise it. I then head off to the neurology ward to find a patient. I met with a doctor who, after teasing me for carrying around my whole bag all day, is quite keen on teaching. So he takes us to the sweetest patient, who kindly lets us examine her upper limb. By the time our actual consultant arrives, we still haven't taken a patient history, so me and 2 friends rush back to work, later accompanied by the doctor. Of course, we do not end up examining the lower limb, but the cranial nerves, which I haven't revised at all this year. After staying in for the extra teaching, it's now 4 p.m, when I should be on a Zoom call for work. I end up taking my laptop to a corner with a surprisingly empty chair. Halfway through, I realize there's the most beautiful sunset in the background. A doctor notices me and, probably thinking I'm super keen for being in hospital at 7 p.m, asks me whether I'd like to see an interesting ECG. Unable to ever turn down offers for teaching in hospital, I immediately accept, get his number, and wrap up work and rush down to see him. Not only does the ECG turn out to be incredibly interesting, but I also get to see a fascinating set of brain MRIs. After my doctor gets called off for a thrombectomy, I finally can guiltlessly leave hospital at 8 p.m. I'm now starving again, so I first stop up for some sushi and then head back home. I contemplate whether I can afford to go straight to sleep, as I'm completely exhausted. Realizing that's exactly what would happen if I stay in my room, I gather my laptop and bag and head to the lounge. Luckily, it's completely empty, so I manage to get some work done before the night ends. I reread an essay I have due soon and decide to just send it in. I then catch up on emails again and sort out some things for work. I do my mandatory daily MCQs, well, half of them, which were supposed to make me feel better after exploring the depths of what I don't know in hospital today, but they have the exact opposite effect. So I decide it is really time for me to just end the day. I go back to my room, where I put on Karma Medic's new podcast as I fall asleep. I'm due to record one with him this weekend, so I really need to catch up on it first. If you made it so far, thank you so much for spending this time with me. I hope you have a wonderful day yourself. Thanks. Bye.